Doc, stop that. Looks like somebody's in for a licking, huh?
You bet! We're gonna smear him!
All right, wait a minute. Back up now. Steady. It's all right, but six against one. That's not very fair, is it?
Oh, come on, gang.
What's the matter, you? What's it all about?
No, I'm not scared. I'll fight you even.
Well, not if I can help it. You look like you take care of yourself. I just want to know what the gang war is for.
We don't like him. We don't want him in our neighborhood. I'm going to our school. See? I've been living here as long as you, since I was born even.
Yeah. Come on now. Now, let's cut it out. I'm serious. What's the matter? Has he got smallpox?
We don't like his religion.
His religion?
Yeah, he's a dirty...
Yeah, wait a minute. Oh, I think I'm beginning to understand this thing. Yeah, it must be one of those Rat Pack gangs I've read about in the papers who beat up on people.
Mister, we ain't no Rat Pack.
Well, you ain't regular guys, for sure, I can tell you that. I don't know what you're to do about this. You must be pretty tough, huh?
You bet.
What about your dad? What kind of a man is he? What would he say about this?
My pop's so tough, he'll smear you.
He would, huh? He's a pretty tough guy, huh?
You bet. He's a sergeant in the army. He was wounded in Korea.
Oh, he was wounded, huh? Say, I'll bet he got some of that blood plasma that you've been reading about, the Red Cross.
You bet. It was hurt so bad, he had to get it 6 times. He told me even.
6 times, huh? Son, anybody in your family ever go to the blood bank?
My mother and father both.
Hey, it's pretty serious. You know, it could be that his father's blood helped save your dad's life. That's pretty bad, isn't it?
Bad about it.
Well, don't you see? His father doesn't go to the same church as your father. Now, you think maybe your dad would rather have died than to take blood from a man of another religion? Would you have wanted him to die, or your mom?
No.
Well, don't you understand, fellas? Religion doesn't make any real difference. God created everybody. God didn't create one people better than another. And people worship God in different ways all over the world. Many, many different ways. Now, my father came from Italy, but I'm an American. But should I hate you because your dad came from Ireland or Sweden or Holland? Now, wouldn't I be a fathead? You guys, by chance, remember anything about Pearl Harbor? You ever read about it or hear about it?
You bet I did. My Uncle Mike was in the Navy.
Oh, he was. Now, did he ever tell you about a battleship, Jap battleship called the Haruna?
No.
Let me see if I can remember. It seems that the Haruna was raising the dickens with our boys, and one day one of our planes sighted it and got right over it. And you know what it takes to bomb a battleship, fellas? It takes teamwork and a lot of guts and know-how. And one of our planes got over it and dropped a big 500-pound bomb right smack in the middle of it. And everybody in the United States kind of threw their head back and felt a lot better about that. Now, the pilot of that airplane was Colin Kelly. He was an American and a Presbyterian. You know who dropped the bombs? A boy from Brooklyn named Meyer Levin, an American and a Jew. Now, do you think maybe they should have called off the whole bombing raid because they weren't of the same religion? Do you? Of course not. Don't be silly. And don't let anybody make suckers out of you. Use your good heads. And let's have no more of this fighting. Well, I'll see you around. I gotta go to work.
What do you work?
I sing.
Oh, you're a kid.
I'll tell you what. You just stand right here, and no hissing allowed.
What is America to me? A name, a map, or a flag I see. A certain word, democracy. What is America to me? The house I live in, a plot of earth, a street, the grocer and the butcher, and the people that I meet, the children in the playground, the faces that I see, all races and religion, that's America to me. The place I work in, the worker by my side. The little town or city where my people lived and died. The howdy and the handshake, the air of feeling free, and the right to speak my mind out. That's America to me. The things I see about me, the big things and the small, the little corner newsstand and the house a mile tall, the wedding and the churchyard, the laughter and the tears, and the dream that's been a-growing for 160 years. The town I live in, the street, the house, the room, the pavement of the city, or a garden all in bloom, the church, the school, the clubhouse, the million lights I see, but it's special. That's America to me.
Well, I'll see you around, boys. Bye now.